So yesterday, a lot of things happened after the live eviction show, different discussions and stuff. Normally, there would have been a fight in the house. At least somebody would have confronted another person before, you know, they start exchanging words and stuff. That's the normal thing that would have happened with the way Ebuka broke tables and stuff. But with the strikes that have been flying up and down, everybody is just trying to respect themselves. Because I know that V, the way she was looking, it's as if she was ready to fight Erica yesterday. But Lekan just told her to calm down. And then later on, she just said, okay, she's not going to like have this... Normally, that fight would have happened. I don't even like the fact that now Biggie is just making everything look like, oh, you cannot even confront somebody, you cannot like talk to the person, you cannot say your mind and stuff. Because when he called those people that had fights, he called even those that did not have physical touch. He just called everybody out, everybody that had the fight out. So now they'll be looking at it like, oh, okay, how am I supposed to fight? If I do like this, am I wrong? Like, they don't even know what's wrong and what's right again. It's now looking like once you shout at somebody, you're going to get a strike, because they've been getting strikes for different things that have been happening in the house. Everybody's now being too careful. First, let me just talk about all the discussions and all the things, major things that happened yesterday. But before we go into that discussion, let me just welcome you guys to my channel. Welcome back to my channel, guys. It's your favorite Apropos girl, Anita. If you're new to this channel, please do well to subscribe and turn on post notifications so that you can get notified each time I post a video. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. So today's video shout out goes to Demi Lade Nigeria, a bottle of red wine for you. So Ozo and Nengi, let's start with Ozo and Nengi. They were having different conversations yesterday. In fact, they showed us the head of house lounge for like 30 minutes or more, and I was looking at Kayode like, so you can show us the head of house lounge like this. So when they showed us, like, Nengi was talking to Ozo about the fact that she doesn't like people that like to be politically correct all the time, that she likes people that when it's time to support somebody, they're going to support you to the fullest, not the one that maybe you'll be trying to sit on the edge or trying not to like trying to please everybody and stuff. That she doesn't like people like that, that see for herself that she has been fighting with her mom since when she was small. She grew up in the hood, so you know all this neighbor fight. Now she has been following her mom to go and do all those kind of fights since she was small, so that's what she has known. And she likes people that will support you like that to the fullest. That even the way he answered this question about Prince and Tolani, but he was there trying to be politically correct about the whole thing, trying to be diplomatic and stuff. So she was just telling him that on Sha. Then they now went on to discuss about other things. She was not talking to him about when he picked Prince to be on his team. I don't even know how come they even brought back that conversation, but she was talking to him about that day that he set her up to fail. I'm like, are you guys serious? Is it that deep? So the summary of that part of the discussion is that she was saying that she doesn't feel like he has a back fully, that he is just trying to always be like please everybody and stuff. Then I entered another discussion when Nengi said why she stopped talking to Prince. She said that he's too competitive, that he's all about the game. So let me just show you guys the video.
I was the one that stopped talking to you. Like, I was the one, the reason why I stopped talking to him, I told him, is because I feel he's more about the game than friendships. He will always choose the game. He's too competitive. I feel like he didn't really value our friendship as much. And I don't really like to be around those kind of people that will choose the game. I mean, of course you choose the game over me, but let it not be too obvious that it's just the game.
When I saw that video, I was like, this doesn't make any sense to me at all. Like, how can you say you stop talking to somebody because he's too competitive, it's all about the game, da-da-da-da-da. And it's not as if maybe you said, okay, we're not going to be too close anymore. She literally stopped talking to him. In fact, I've always wondered, like, what happened between Nengi and Prince? They were very close at some point, and then all of a sudden, she's no more talking to him at all. Like, you know that kind of thing where you're literally just angry with the person? So I was wondering, like, what exactly happened between these two that she's just like vexing for Prince or what? And I didn't even understand it. Then now she's now saying because it's too competitive, which did not make sense to me. There has to be another reason. That kind of, like, okay, let's just go by what she said. It's like saying that you are not close to somebody, or you're not talking to somebody again because he's focused. Because that's the only way that I'm looking at it right now. Because he's like, if you say he's all about the game, means that he's focused. And Nengi that we all know is like so focused on the game. She's one person that I know is very conscious of the camera. She's conscious of what she says, what she does. Like, all that is in her mind is, okay, she knows that she's here for the money and she has to focus on that. So how would you say that you stop talking to somebody because he is also focused? The way I see it, then she just looked at Prince and she looked at Ozan like, okay, this one, I feel like I can be able to, like, I can be in control of this one. So let me just go with this guy. Because Prince, the way Prince was going, he was very unstable. You can't say today, he'll be like, oh, mushy mushy. Tomorrow, he'll not even answer her and stuff. So maybe she felt like, this one, I can't really trust this one. I can't really handle this one. So because that reason she gave, it did not gel to me at all. So the shower went on to other conversations where they were talking about who she will pick as deputy head of house if she wins. And I'm like, hey, wonderful. People are now giving, and people are now discussing that kind of thing. So they now, the list came down to Trikiti and Lekan. So it's either going to be Trikiti and Lekan. They cancelled Prince, cancelled Kidwaya, and all those other people that he's not comfortable with. Because she told him that she's going to pick who he's comfortable with. So all these other people were cancelled from the list. It now boiled down to Trikiti and Lekan. Later on, she was also saying that she really likes Prince because he's smart. Like, it's almost like she was trying to like correct what she said before that. It's not as if she doesn't like him, that she likes him because he's smart and all of that and all of that, but he's too all about the game. Although I didn't understand the reason why she was now trying to say all those ones. Then Ozo was now saying, oh, so I'm not smart. She was not like, it's not about you, that it's not that deep, it's not a competition and stuff. I'm like, Ozo, what's wrong with you? Like, why bringing your matter into the equation? They shall talk, and later it was time for them to go to bed. Nengi now faced her own part and was lying down. She now told him good night. He did not answer her. She was not saying, you need to answer me, you need to answer my good night. Ozo did not answer her. He just kept mute. The next thing, he even turned to the other side of the bed and was just like, he just completely ignored. She just kept touching him that, say good night now, will you say good night? Then he did not answer her at all. I'm like, hey, Ozo, it's like he has received sense. That's for just yesterday night. She was not telling him that she better keep the same energy there because tomorrow they will not talk or whatever it is. Ozo did not answer, he did not say anything. I'm like, this one is payback for that day that he was begging her, she did not answer. Today is now her turn. Then I need to also mention that they are now using the same duvet. I told the guys that from that wall of Jericho that has gone, the next thing will be for them to now share the same duvet. From coming to the head of house lounge with her duvet, they are now using the same duvet. I'm like, what's now the point of doing the wall of Jericho in the first place? Like, it did not even, there's no point moving from this to this. Like, just relax. That's it for Ozo and Nengi. Let's now move over to Erica. Erica confronted Lekan and V to talk about what happened on the live show, and they both declined. I mean, I'm like, I know that it's okay to like want to talk to somebody about an issue, but it's not every time you need to confront somebody and talk about something, especially when it's not everything that is necessary to talk about. Like, you already said what you said about V, so what is the conversation about? Like, why are you trying to have a conversation? Onto what? You said she's not your friend and everything, and we outside were already saying, one and stuff. Then you now go back and try to talk to her that what are you talking about? What do you want to settle? The next thing, she starts saying she knows that V doesn't like her, when both of you are like doing what you're doing to yourself. So like, what was the point of trying to get the conversation out of her? Lekan zone, I understand small, because I expected her to actually go and meet him. I knew that she'll go and meet him. Then Lekan shall decline. Although Lekan said today that he's going to talk to her later, he felt like the situation was going to go out of hand. That's why he didn't talk to her. He talked to her later. Erica already said this morning that she's not going to talk to him, but I know that she's going to talk. Erica, that I know, that cannot stay without talking about something. To be happy for her in her chest. So let's see how they go with that one. Then she also had a conversation with Prince concerning the Tolani badge matter, where she was telling Prince the discussion that Tolani badge had with her and stuff. She just opened her mouth and said everything. Wow. I'm like, it's not small thing. She told him about when Tolani badge said something about liking Neo, it was Neo that was there, that was the first choice, before Prince came into the picture. She just said a lot of things about their discussion. Normally I would have looked at this conversation like, Erica, why are you even saying this kind of thing to him? And like, Tolani badge is your friend and all of that. But if I'm looking at it critically, there are several reasons why I feel like Tolani badge is not somebody, like, I won't really feel bad because it's Tolani badge. Because one, Tolani badge has done this kind of thing to like so many of her friends in the house, almost all her friends in the house. She has done something to them. Like V, now that she nominated V to leave that time, she's also talking about her man in that way, like, oh, I like this guy and stuff. Like, those two things alone, and V is like the closest person to her. Then is it the one that she did to Watoni by going to tell Brighto all that Watoni said, or the one that she did to Erica by telling Watoni that there was comms thing? So Tolani badge already did a lot to them. So I'm not even going to say that, oh, I feel some kind of way about Erica saying all that. And she now said those things to him. Prince, on his own part, was now having mixed feelings. Like, okay, am I supposed to feel bad that this babe left, or I'm going to feel betrayed, or I'm going to feel sad that this is what she's saying about somebody else when we are together and stuff? Like, different feelings. But I know he'll be alright, Sha. He'll be very okay, because I don't think he like liked her like deeply. So I don't think it will get to him for so long. And he has a friend in the house, Dorothy, so they can always like chill and just together. So It's not that deep, Jerry. Then there's another video that I saw, Erica and Kidwire together. I did not watch this live. So the video showed, the way the video was almost like Kidwire was trying to wear his undies. They were in bed and he was trying to wear his undies. And a lot of people said that, oh, they just finished doing things. But after I saw the video, somebody sent it to me on Instagram too. Somebody also sent it on Instagram. I don't know if the person wants to be mentioned here, so I'm just going to leave that part. So I shall watch the video. Then I said, let me even check the comments and know what exactly happened. And a lot of people in the comments were saying that like nothing really happened, that he was just trying to, I think they said he wanted to wear his shorts and then leave the room and stuff, which he later did. So we can't really say what exactly happened. You know the way Kayode is, like, he'd be going in, coming out, going in and coming out. So it's not something that it's speculation. Basically, it's speculation, because so far you did not see what exactly happened then. Probably something happened or something did not happen. So it's just speculation that people are doing. And those in the comment section that watched it said that that's not what happened. And I was particular about, oh, maybe is this person an Erica fan and stuff. It did not look like the person was coming from a place of bias. So I'm just going to believe whatever the person said, because I did not watch it. And as for Erica and Kidwire, there's nothing new. They've already done everything before today. Is it makeout? Is it intercourse? They've done everything before today. So there's really, really nothing new. If I even see two of them now, like in the open. In fact, moving on. Erica told me something yesterday night that if she was not with Kidwire, that it would have been him. I don't know whether that one is joke or be serious. Like, where did that talk even come from? Neo should not allow that one enter his head. Because yesterday, Neo was looking like he was feeling himself. Like, oh, I'm now like most wanted. All the girls are coming for me. Neo should not allow that one get into his head. So far as I'm concerned, maybe she's looking for people that will not vote her out of the house or something. I don't know, but I didn't even understand where that was coming from. Well, different discussions happen, Nisha. We are going to see a different voting process today. So I'm curious to know the people that are going to be up for possible evictions. Let us just be watching. If you're still here to this point, please give this video a big thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'm going to see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys. Love you.